Let's understand this by taking a circus ring. Let's assume that this has a constant diameter of 30 centimeters. We can easily find out the circumference of the ring using circumference equals to pi multiplied by diameter. In this case, 3.14 multiplied by 30, that is 90.4 centimeters.
I know this concept, but how does it help in finding the distance covered by a vehicle?
Alright, now let's rotate the circus ring one complete round. The distance covered in one complete revolution is 90.4 centimeters as calculated previously. You can open the circus ring and arrange all the pieces in a straight line and measure the distance. It will be the same.
Wow, that's interesting.
This math is used in circular tires of the vehicles also. If a wheel has a diameter of 80 centimeters, then its circumference will be 80 multiplied by 3.14, that is 251.2 centimeters. It means the wheel will cover this distance in one complete revolution. So for n revolution, we will multiply the circumference with the number of revolutions to get the total distance covered by the wheel.
Cool! But how does this concept used in real-time scenario?
Well, a device called a trundle wheel is used to measure the long distances. A marking is placed on this wheel so that it clicks for one complete revolution. It has a diameter of 31.8 centimeters because then its circumference will be 1 meter using the above formula.
So, you mean to say that this trundle wheel is attached in the tires of all the vehicles?
Yes, as you push the trundle wheel, every click that is recorded on the odometer means that the wheel has gone around once and you have travelled 1 meter.
Wow, got it. So the number of revolutions covered by this wheel multiplied by the circumference gives us the total distance covered. Wow!